Ladies and gentlemen, from the Sheraton Tampa East in Tampa, Florida, bout number 10, 3 1.5-minute rounds, JO division. Boxing out of the red corner, 15 years of age, 138 pounds, representing Dade City Boxing, Jose Diaz.
Oh, Dade City, he said.
Boxing out of the blue corner, 16 years of age, 132 pounds, representing Legends Boxing, Ivan Franco.
Just Franco.
You know how here's how I got confused. When I've been looking at the corner pad, look, that corner pad's red, that's blue.
Plus,
they're reversed.
On our page, we've got blue on the right, but it's actually here. We got red, it's over there.
Correct. That's what messed me up. That helps, yeah.
Upside down makes it better for me. I'm used to that.
All right, let's get serious. These guys are pretty good size, JOs. 138 pounds. 132. They're still using 10-ounce gloves. Yeah. I can hear them. Good body work. Good body work. The kid from Legends is going to have to start firing punches, Don. You know, he's blocking him okay, but you got to fire him. Let's score.
Go ahead. Keep going.
Yeah, he's really having his way with this lad. He's kind of just taking charge. I will say that the kid from Legends is able to block punches, but he just is not getting off offensively.
Just not scoring.
Yeah. Well, he landed a good jab right there, but I don't think he landed enough punches to influence the judges to win that round. So the kid in the red, the blue, actually the red corner, this kid, Jose Diaz, he definitely won that round. Ivan Franco? Yeah. He's going to have to pick it up. Cause I'm no comedian. Jokers are wild. If you won't be tame, I treat you like a child, then you're gonna be named another enemy, not even a friend of me. Cause you'll be fried in the end when you pretend to be competing. Cause I just put your mind on pause and I can. Yeah, he's tough, this kid. Good right hand there, right down a pipe. Good triple combination. See that? He fired on that kid, left, right, left hook. He really works the body up. Trying to see what he was calling there. I couldn't see the referee's hand signal. Wasn't sure what he was calling.
Low blow.
Was it low? Yeah, this kid's outscoring. This kid from Legends is outscoring his opponent about 5-1, 6-1. Ivan Franco. These JOs, 1.5 minute. Boy, he hit him right hand left hook. Yeah. He's really scoring on this kid. Man, that boy's got a big set of whiskers there.
Because I ain't no joke.
Man, that Ivan Franco.
Franco, I guess Franco the first two rounds.
Yeah, easy. Jose Diaz picked up his offense a little bit that round. He actually came back firing. He did land some combinations. This kid's strong. For 132 pounds, this Franco kid's tough. Strong. When I had Oscar De La Hoya the first time in the Nationals, he was 139 pounds. The first guy broke his nose first round, even with the bigger gloves. Knocked him out. Second bout that I had him, he did the same thing. Knocked the guy out in the second round, broke his nose. He had that hand up like that. His hands were like a rattlesnake. He was so quick. Man, he hit hard. He knocked both of them down, too. All right, here we go. This is a, wow. This Franco kid's rough. Now, that's a pro technique there.
Yeah, is that legal?
No, I call him about using that forearm.
That's a forearm push.
Yeah, you can't do that. A lot of referees won't call him. I call him and tell him, you can't use that forearm like football. You can't hit a guy. Because you can end up hurting a guy, especially with no helmet. You know, hit him in the face, break his nose, break his jaw. They do it on purpose. You know, Mayweather uses his elbow a lot. They all got tricks. Oh, a much better round for this kid.
Yes.
This Jose Diaz has picked it up third round. He's back in the fight a little bit. I don't think he'll do enough to win it, but he certainly got back in the fight. He's firing now. I guess he got tired of eating that leather, huh? What do you think, Don? I've had enough of that leather sandwich for tonight. Yeah, look at Diaz. Look at him. He rocked him. Wow.
Well, could be a 2-1.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I'd call that Ivan Franco the first two rounds, and maybe Diaz picked up that third round.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, he really started fighting. I was impressed with that comeback. He actually rocked this kid a couple times, Franco. Is that bout number
10?
Yeah. So we got another novice. Those are heavyweights. I don't know what that Y is.
Probably supposed to be a B.
Oh, it's a B? Just novice, that's what, yeah. They wrote Nov, okay. That'll be a couple of big boys,
yeah.
So we have to be aware that we don't get hurt here at ringside.
Okay.
These guys come over the ropes. I'm not going to catch them this time. I ended up in the hospital on the 11th, this hand right here.
Yeah.
And I got a CT scan. Shannon Briggs knocked me and Frank Gentile out of the high stool. Back under the first row, under Phil Alessi's thing, I tried to spear them. They were coming out of the ring, two 256-pound guys.
Uh-huh.
And this hand went back. You can see where it's still the tendon.
Yeah.
I'll show you a picture. It's a horrendous look.
Ladies and gentlemen, before the decision, let's have a great round of applause for both boxers, please.
Well, let's see what the judges say.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Sheridan Tampa East in Tampa, Florida, your winner of bout number 10 by unanimous decision, coming out of the blue corner, Ivan Franco. Ladies and gentlemen, before our final bout, how about a nice round of applause for a very hard-working group of people, our officials from USA Boxing, doing such a great job. And they work very hard, and we're very appreciative of the work they do.
I hit Briggs so hard.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Sheridan Tampa East in Tampa, Florida, bout number 11, three two-minute rounds, novice division. Boxing out of the red corner, 20 years of age, 223 pounds, representing SJC Boxing, Brandon Rivas.
And I had to get a CT scan because my
I've had that broken neck and a head injury.
Boxing out of the blue corner, 26 years of age, 218 pounds, representing Bulldog Boxing, Kelly Miner.
6 hours. And I didn't have a break. That's pretty expensive.
Yes.
Thank you, my friend.
All right, here we go.
They say the average cost for chest pain, like if you chest pain, say, well, you better go to the hospital. That could be hard. $10,000.
Yeah.
That's if there's nothing wrong with it.
Yeah. All right, sports fans, here we go. We got the big boys.
Got the big boys right here.
Yeah, Don. Who are they?
They saved the big to last.
Tell me who they are.
Oh, they're busy.
Yep.
We got Brandon Rivas against Kelly Moore.
Okay. Brandon Rivas is in the blue corner or the red corner?
Red corner.
Red corner. And Kelly Moore is in the blue corner. Okay.
They are 223 and 218, respectively.
Yeah, these are the biggest guys of the night. They weigh as much as about the first 10 fighters.
Yes, that's right.
They are big boys.
But they are in the novice division.
Yeah, 223, 218. Well, the boy in the red looks a little more experienced than a novice to me. But then again, he just may have talent, you know?
Yeah. Well, he's 20 years old.
Yeah.
His opponent's 26.
Yeah, well, they're still young boys. For us, I mean, they're like kids.
Well, they say heavyweights can start late and still have an effective career, but do you think 26 at the novice level is too late?
Too late. Yeah, unless you're just a phenomenal athlete. You know, maybe you came from basketball players convert to boxers real easy because basketball is a very quick switch to offense, defense, just like boxing. And they have great athletic ability and a lot of leverage. Football players don't transfer very well.
No, they don't.
They're used to running into people. This guy's pretty sharp, see? He's having his way with him.
Yes, he is.
You know, even though he's a novice, he's got a good concept of boxing and defending, counterpunching. See, he kept that hand up there. He's blocking those shots, you know, those wild shots. So that young man.
Yeah, I think Kelly Moore.
Kelly Moore, yeah.
He did a paint job there.
Yeah, he painted him, that's for sure. I would say that was definitely, he leathered him, as they say in England. He gave the man a good leathering. And Kelly looks like he's been around a little bit. I'm sure he's had a lot of gym work. He's relaxed. The other boy's pretty relaxed. He seemed to be fit. Probably just doesn't have the experience. What happens, a lot of guys will box when they're young. They don't really get serious. And they've never had sanction bouts. And all of a sudden, then they show up doing sanction bouts. But yet they've had maybe 15 bouts somewhere.
Okay.
You know, could have been in the backyard.
Right.
But they've been in there, you know. Round number two. Kelly Moore in the red. And Brandon Rivas is in the black trunks.
Yes.
Kelly seems to throw a very nice combination, but I don't like the way he drops his hands, Don. If he gets in with an experienced open fighter, he's going to pay for that. You know, fight with his hands down in front of him. In this particular bout, he's up against a guy who just doesn't have a skill set yet. But if he gets in against a good open, they're going to make him pay. And that's a bad habit to get into, dropping your hands. That's a habit you can't have a hard time to break. See, now, boy's starting to come in on him a little bit.
Yes, he is. As some trading in it.
Yeah, as amateur as he is, and, you know, he doesn't have the skill sets yet, but still, he showed you there, he walked and worked his way in. And Kelly let that happen by dropping his hands down. See, Rivas caught him there with a little looping left hook coming in. Yeah, Kelly's coach is going to have to really work with him about keeping those hands up. He's slapping a little bit too, you notice? those punches, Don, are not pronated. No, we call that the pronation. He's just kind of slapping. He's getting tired. See, that was a big, loud slap.
Blowing hard.
Oh, he is, yeah. Mouth open. Mm-hmm. This kid's starting to hit him a little bit, see? Looks like he's got a bloody mouth. Maybe. Could be just a mouthpiece. Maybe he's got a bloody nose, I don't know. But he's getting hit a little bit.
Yeah. And, think he lost that round?
I don't know if he lost it, but he didn't impress many with that round. He kind of took the round off, as we say in the pros.
Yeah.
Kind of took the round off. And, he showed me some more fatigue because his hands actually, instead of being about waist high, it was third down.
Yeah.
So when you get heavy hands, you're tired. That's what happens.
Blowing hard in the corner.
Yeah, he's having a hard time recovering. This kid over here, Diaz, he seems to recover. He's not breathing hard at all. I'll tell you, in the pros, that's something the corners will look at. They'll take a look at an opponent. They see him over there gassed, you can bet your bottom dollar they're going to tell their guy. Mm-hmm. They put a lot of pressure on a guy, really increase the pressure. Yeah, Diaz looks like he's a little more in a reserve tank, you know? Let's see what happens this final round. See, Kelly's still got that left hand low. Uh-oh. Oh, his head equipment popped off. Yeah, Kelly's got a lot of basic skills. He's got to work on really improving that defense, getting those hands up. He's got to learn to move a little more with his head and shoulders. But, you know, that's why they're in the novice division. They haven't had very many bouts. He's still getting hit with some shots he shouldn't be.
Mm-hmm.
And he could control this much better if he kept his hands up. This boy's getting more aggressive, Diaz. He's really starting to put pressure on him. See what I'm saying? Wow, this thing turning around right here. This big boy ain't going away. I think Diaz has just got a little more in the tank, Don.
Yes.
Looks to me like Diaz has got a full tank.
Uh-huh.
Those punches of Kelly.
Yep.
Kelly's punches started to become powder punches.
Yep.
Yeah, see there, he's getting hit with that right hand.
He's winning this round big.
Yeah. Kelly's just kind of reaching down the grab bag, grabbing anything he can get his hands on, hoping that they hear that bell. He can't wait for that bell to ring.
Pot shot him.
Yeah, he pot shot him. Kelly doesn't have much left in those hands.
No, he doesn't.
His helmet doesn't fit very well either. It's up over his chin. Good way to get hurt. Surprised the referee is letting it go. I would stop and put that helmet back on. You know, when that helmet was up like that.
Well, how do you call it? Tough.
I don't know. What do you think?
Well, I think the last round was the most decisive in the bunch, but it's still only a round.
Yeah. I think Kelly probably won the first two rounds, and I'd say Diaz probably won the third round, so.
Yeah.
The call probably will go to Kelly Moore. Judges have been pretty consistent tonight. I think they've been pretty good.
Well, how difficult is it in amateur scoring if you've lost two of the three rounds to have a big enough final round
really hard
to offset one of those others?
It is really hard. You would have to really dominate that final round.
More than we saw in the third round tonight.
You'd have to almost come up with a 10-7 round.
Okay.
Yeah. If you lost the first two, you're going to really probably have to have a standing eight count, a knockdown, and dominate. Yes. You'd really have to dominate. Yeah. Once you get behind, it's tough for your round bound. I kept my hand in ice every night for 2 weeks and tried to get that thing. Then I wore an ace bandage, but it just those ligaments and tendons, you know.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, before the decision, let's have a nice round of applause for both boxers, please.
It takes longer.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Sheridan Tampa East in Tampa, Florida, your winner of bout number 11 by unanimous decision. The winner coming out of the blue corner, Kelly Miner.
Kelly Miner. It's Miner, yeah.
It's Miner, okay.
We've been saying more. I apologize. It's Kelly Miner.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to thank all of our sponsors.
Whoever
this
scripted
evening,
that thing, Don, we got to take them back to cursive.
Club and the Yared Foundation for the 2014 Florida Boxing Hall of Fame induction weekend.